Hello everyone, welcome back to your Netcode-Hub channel. So in this video, we're going to talk about progressive web apps. So as usual, let's refer to a small notes so we can actually have a look, read what we explain. Alright, so what is progressive web app? So in the short, we call it as PWA, so progressive web app. Now, progressive web application uses modern web APIs and capabilities to behave like desktop or native. So the native here does not even need internet connection to work. Okay, so it looks like it behaves like a desktop or native mobile application. So that is what the progressive web application is. It uses the modern browser APIs and it behaves as if it is like a desktop or native mobile application that we normally install on our mobile phones and our computer systems. Now, progressive web applications have the following capabilities. One, it's able to load data instantly. So it is capable of working offline. Even when there's no internet, it can still work with the data that it has. Now, it supports push notifications. So when you have a notification, it gets you. It's not like a normal website or web applications where you have notifications, you don't get it. But with the PWA, when you have a notification, quick, you get it. Now, it is automatic or self-update, so it updates itself automatically without a button click from the user. Now, it also has an app launch option, so you can start the app by clicking on the icon to open it. And it can also run on its own Windows. So, PWA has its own window that you can actually run itself in. Then, ask yourself this question whenever you want to create an application. So am I going to create a native application, web app, hybrid app, or progressive app? Now, what is native app? Let's actually have a look at all these apps. Now, the native app, these apps provide fast, reliable, and responsive to users, which support only one platform. So it could be for, if it is just programming C# for Windows, you're going to create a software or an application for Windows. And aside from installing the application for Windows, you can't install the same application on Mac OS or Linux. If you want to do that, unless you rewrite the code, so that's a certain, unless you write a multiple code to run a different platform, so you're going to change the code, the language that you use for the Windows, you use a different one for the different platform with the same application. Now, it is very easy to access device hardware like cameras, microphone, etc. Because when it is stored on your mobile phone or your computer, you can actually have access to cameras and this hardware, right? Yeah, it's possible to have access to them. Now, with a starting 2.2, it consumes more time, cost, and effort. Because what here? I'm going to create the same application for Windows. You have to rewrite the same code for Mac, rewrite the same code for Linux. Talk about the time. Calculate the time that's going to take, your effort, and your cost. Massive. Now, then what is web app? Web app is quicker and easier to build. As you know, web applications, you can build it very fast and easy as well. Now, it can be accessed on any device, on any platform. So whether you're having Windows, Mac, Linux, etc., you can still have access to. The only thing that you need here is what? It's your browser. But the sad thing is, not all browsers can actually support it. Other browsers you can use to browse even that specific website that you have created. So it also has a sad side or sad thing as well. Then let's talk about the hybrid app. So hybrid one, what is hybrid? That's a combination of web app and a native app. So with this hybrid, it's able to access request or capable of what, performing the push notification. It's able to access its hardware natively. It also provides fast and reliable responsive user, which also support one platform as well. Now with the hybrid, combination of native and web app, now it has one code base and can run on all platforms. So whether it is Mac OS, whether it is Windows or Linux, you need one code and it's still going to run on all. Then let's go to the master one, that's the progressive app, the PWA. Now, you know, we've talked about the progressive app that this work in a web browser. It supports what, push notifications. It also works on all mobile platforms, Android, all platforms it works on. So, our next video, let's talk about how do you create a progressive web app. All that we've talked about, let's put them to practice by creating a progressive web application by using the Blazor web assembly to create a progressive. Let's talk about that in the next video. So let's give it a break. When you return, you're going straight ahead to create it. For now, get the knowledge, get the basic, get the concept, and now you move on with the next video.